So, now we get to button 17 on layer 4. This button is called Artillery, and we will see why that's the case. So here is our plane. As always, I will first add the plane to the rigid body system and then prevent that it gets selected. And now I need, let's say, one or two objects. I will make one cone object here. And add one icosphere. Also go a little bit up and a little bit to the right. So, and these two I want to place in an own collection. Move to collection, new, and the name is bullets. So now let me see the tooltip of the button. So let's go to layer 4 and see the tooltip of the button. So what does it say? Generate animation keyframes for artillery fire, including explosion. Move the animation slider starting frame. Selected bullet objects and add them to collection A. So as always, we first add the bullet objects to collection A. And then we need again a target empty. And we have the two options. So this is technically the same like 16, but we have a bullet explosion on the target. So let's see that. You need to know that this is technically already getting to the limit what Blender can do in Python in an acceptable amount of time. So using this extensively will use a lot of time, not even for rendering, but just for preparing the keyframes. You will see that. So we have the bullets and we add them to collection A using the right mouse button on button 16. So they are there. Now I need a target empty. Empty here. So this is the target empty. This is the direction we are going to shoot. Also what will happen is they will shoot here, and here we will start with an explosion. And now I'm going to press the left button and I'm going to wait, because the left button, everything is completely automatic. So it's already working. I must not do anything more. It has default parameters. So while it's working, we can take a look on that. Here we see it. This is technically what's inside. These are the default parameters. The right button, if I take the right button, I get an input box and I can choose the number, the length, the depth of these artilleristic shots, and they will also be used here. So left button is default parameters, right button you can choose three parameters. And there is an auto bake also included. This means this is going to bake automatically after the shots are produced. So it took 82 seconds and we have used 2 more seconds for baking. And now let's look what happens. So that's why it takes a lot of time. This is Okay, I should have added the ground floor as passive. Plane select rigid body box and passive. And we need to bake it quickly. So let's look at it again. So you see the bullets shoot up to the target somewhere with some distribution, and there they explode just a little bit like a firework. So this is the default version. There is another version that is on the right mouse button that will have some parameters that you can change, the speed and some other parameters. So, but notice here a lot of objects and keyframes get produced, so this really takes a while. Technically, the bullets from this cone get into an own collection, and the bullets from the icosphere get into an own collection. So we can just delete them if we like. Made a mistake. Okay. We'll see if I can repair them. So you see it's 280 clones from each of them. Delete. So now we are back to the original, to the starting of the scene. This is our target empty, and let's try to do something with this. For this I will set the 3D cursor here, and these two, no, I want it here. And these three, I only want these two. These two, I would like to move a little bit more here, this direction. And now I say layer two, make a round tower at position of 3D cursor, hey, and radius, hey, I want 40, radius is 20, so it's not a large round tower. Oh, did I say it's not large? Okay, I would like to reduce it in size anyway using this. So now put it on the floor. So the first thing I will do is, the tower is in an own collection, of course. I will bake this just to see if it's stable so far and how long it takes. So we see here that the round tower alone is not really fast with baking and will take several minutes. So we will have to wait for that to be ready. Okay, we are ready. Let's see how it looks so far. Good. Our tower is mostly stable. Not totally stable, but stable enough. So now we need a start frame and an empty. Have been empty. So arrows, there is it. So where do we shoot? We shoot to here. And now we put the two The cube, where's the cube? Ah, this is the base cube for the tower, so we just leave that. So this one I don't need. I need this one. So this one we place here a bit in front of the tower. And relatively high. So let me see the weight. They have 2000 kilos and they have. They are not even rigid bodies. We should work on that. I give them 100 kilos. And this one. I give this 14 kilos. Is okay for that. So we have these two. I put them in selection A using the right mouse button on button 16. And then I will mark the target object, which is this. And then we can shoot using the left button. Which of course will take a while. So after 30 minutes of calculation and baking, as you see here, we have a result. Let's play. But it's not perfect, we are too far from the castle. So we go back. I say here are the bullets and here is my plank. If I go to layer 1, I can make select similar size. I get the tower. I move the tower more near to my explosions. And I have to bake it again. Which takes time. We see here it uses 1.6 seconds per frame. So the baking is ready. This time it took only 6 minutes. Let's see how it looks. So now we are really attacking the building. Okay, so this is button artillery A, and we have also artillery B. Now, let's see. What can we do? We should also test the artillery B, which has some parameters. And then I take my two bullets here. They are here. Ooh, they are really far away. And what do I need? Okay, also this thing here works with here we are. 1, 2. These are the two source bullets. I take just one here and move it a little bit down. And this here to here. And now let me move both to this side. And put them in collection A. Then I need my target empty. And this I make directly in front of the building. Or, oh, this is even. Yeah, it's very much in front of the building. And now I try artillery number B. Right button. The number is 40, the length is 20, and the next parameter is really crucial. If you want to wait overnight and maybe even the next day, then you make for depth a 2. 2 would mean that each explosion will explode again. So this is giving the explosion of the explosion. If you use 2 here, I don't recommend that it uses too much time, so for the moment stay with 1. This is the length of the explosion path. I would set this to 10 for now. And we make 40 bullets, that's a lot. I make only 20 bullets for now. And this will take enough time before it's done. So we are done. Again. Around the same time like before. Now let's see how it looks. Okay. Oh, this ball flies really fast. You just see it here. Then comes the explosion. So, okay, that is the B. The B is a lot of faster. Maybe I need to place it in a further distance. So the artillery thing is more for firework-like stuff. It shoots somewhere and then it makes these nice explosions. You can even tell it to explode the explosion objects again by using the depth option. But I do not really recommend it, unless your computer is much faster than my computer. So first we connect the button bar and Blender. And this time we want to look on button 18. And 18 is a very simple button. Let me first add this to the rigid body system and prevent it from being touched. And then I will add a UV sphere and move it a little bit up. So. Can we make okay. So now I select the sphere, I go to button 18 and I press the left mouse button. That's all. It's immediately ready and when I press play you will see the effect. It will just explode the ball into many smaller balls. So I can now take some of these balls again and again press the left mouse button and let's see what happens. So we get the please wait symbol, and of course it will take some time because this time we have 9 balls, all of them must be calculated. Okay, it's done. So here in the outliner we have now for each ball an own collection with the explosion balls for it. Now let's look how it looks. So I need more space. So then we get even a larger explosion. So that's one thing you can do. So you can just take, of course, I can make new general, don't save. Going to layer 1, again making this to the rigid body system and prevent it from getting picked. And I will add now something else. I will add, let's say I will add a cube and icosphere, and I will select both. So this will also work. Going to layer 4 and I press button 18. It's working, it's ready. And now if I press play, you will see both of them exploding in the same way. So now you can do something quite different. Let me make a new scene. Again, go to layer 1 and add it to the rigid body system and prevent it from being taken. And now I will make a cube. I could make a rock. Let's start with a cube, it's easier to see. So now I need some add-on, but I don't really know where it is, so let me search it. So I found it. What I want to use is fracture it. So we have a cube here and I want to fracture it and crack it. What's the difference? Make a cracked object from cell objects. And this makes fractured cells from selected object. Okay, I want to start with this. I don't know the parameters, but I want to see the whole process running. Show progress real time exactly. Now I press OK. So he has done something, you see. He just broke it into 4 pieces. Maybe I won't crack it. Wireframe modifier? No, I won't just crack it. So, oh, how does it look? Strange. I thought he would make a little bit more. Hide original, move besides origin, use collection, new collection, debug points, random, 1, child particles, 1, noise, 1, I don't know, I press OK for now. Oh, now he's doing a lot. This takes already a bit longer. So, I have broken it. So at least what we got is this. This is what I wanted to show you. So I'm not going to... oh yeah, that's a lot. So I'm just taking a few of them. Because otherwise it will take until tomorrow. If I take all of them. Just take maybe... some. So, and then I go to layer 4 and make the explode selected. And now you can also do this. So this means you can crack an object and have all this stuff explode, and then it looks of course more authentic than if you just explode some balls or some stuff like this. However, doing this it takes a little bit long, so if you take a lot of parts, you can even go to bed and wait until the next day for sure. So now let's see. Play. Oh yeah, looks better. So this will also work. Is enough. So I want to do it again, but watch a little more what I'm doing. New. Don't save. The plane I want to add to the rigid body. And then I want to add... we take the cube again. And I want to crack it. Okay. Did we do something? No. Use crack it to displace. Okay, no. Then I take fracture it. So child particles 0 and random 1. Okay, let's see. Okay, that's not so much. This is okay. Now we go to layer 4 and we press button 18. And we are working, of course, which will take some time. So, weiter geht's. Da haben wir das Resultat. Lass uns mal laufen. Ach, gibt also wirklich eine schöne Explosion. Da müssen wir jetzt nur noch ein schönes Türmchen außenrum bauen. Na, dann wollen wir mal. Daran soll es nicht fehlen. Gehen wir auf Layer 2 und sagen, ich will mal einen Round Tower hier. Und die Höhe 20 und der Radius 10 reicht völlig aus. Und jetzt ist er vielleicht... Und ich stelle ihn auch ein bisschen nach rechts und hier runter. So, jetzt müsste er noch ein bisschen über dem Boden sein. Jetzt muss er natürlich nochmal gebacken werden. Na, Layer 1 und Bake. Und das sieht man, da strengt sich Blender jetzt schon ein bisschen an, wenn er jetzt die Explosion hat und noch den Tower. Wobei in dem Frame, wo der Tower eingestürzt ist, geht es dann wieder ganz schnell, das sieht man hier auch. Das heißt, am Anfang dauert es ein bisschen länger und dann stürzt der gute Tower ein. Das heißt aber auch, wir sollten den Tower ein bisschen stabiler machen, vielleicht mal. Ja, es wird wieder ein bisschen langsamer. Was passiert da? Na gut, schauen wir es uns erstmal an. Okay, da hat der Tower keine große Chance. So, jetzt kann man natürlich hergehen und sagen, ich nehme die Dinger hier, gehe auf Rigid Body und mache die mal ganz leicht, sagen wir mal 20 Kilo. Wobei, noch habe ich es nicht, jetzt habe ich nur ein einziges Teil 20 Kilo gemacht. Ich muss erst noch auf Copy and Bake, also Taste 7. Und jetzt sehen wir hier, jetzt strengt er sich wieder an. Und wagt hier die Szene. Jetzt sind wir mal gespannt, ob der Turm stehen bleibt. 41 Sekunden. Jetzt möchte ich mal sehen. Bam. Hat es trotzdem umgeworfen. Wenn wir uns das jetzt mal anschauen. Der einzelne Bollen hat jetzt nur noch ein Gewicht von 20 Kilo. Also. Und eine Planke hier in dem Turm hat ein Gewicht von 2000 Kilo. Jetzt schauen wir uns das mal an, was das bewirkt. Trotzdem reißt es durch die Schnelligkeit, durch die kinetische Energie hier den Turm weg. Gut, dann mache ich Folgendes. Ich sage 5 Kilo. Das ist jetzt wirklich nicht viel. Und dann Copy, Rigid Body and Bake. So, und dann bemüht sich unser Blender wieder und berechnet die Simulation. So, in 42 Sekunden und jetzt lassen wir es nochmal laufen. Ha, reißt es trotzdem ab. Gibt's das he? Hat es echt 5 Kilo bloß? Ja, 5 Kilo. 5 Kilo. 5 Kilo. Auch mit nur 5 Kilo reißt er den Turm ab. Also gut, dann können wir auch mal was anderes machen. Ich gehe auf so eine Planke von dem Turm und sage, muss ich das, bin auf Layer 1, Select Similar Size. Und jetzt gebe ich einfach den Planken das zehnfache Gewicht und sage, ihr seid jetzt 20.000 Kilo schwer. Und auch da muss ich natürlich erstmal machen, Copy and Bake. And Bake. Okay, das Bake scheint er nicht gemacht zu haben, dann drücke ich nochmal hier. Has is empty, cannot save. Ach nee, er baked schon. Er baked schon. Das dauert natürlich. Sehen wir ja auch hier. So, und jetzt nochmal schauen. Bin ich mal gespannt. Ha, er reißt es trotzdem um. Mal sehen, was da genau passiert. Turm reinschlagen und ey, das Ganze wegschieben, obwohl die nur 5 Kilo haben und die Planken haben 20.000 Kilo. Ehrlich? Das ist ja sonst schon strange. Okay, jetzt mache ich es richtig. Kriminell. Die alle hier. Die mache ich jetzt. Da ist einer mit 20.000 dabei. Das ist klar, das würde den Turm umreißen. Nee, den will ich ja auf 5, auf 1 Kilo haben. So, 1 Kilo. Die alle. Copy. and bake. So, hat schon angefangen. Hier an dem, da sieht man, dass bei Fremden 40 wohl auch schon der Tower umgefallen ist, weil dann geht es richtig schnell hier. Solange der Tower steht, bakt er etwas langsamer. So, nach 42 Sekunden haben wir es wieder gebaked und jetzt schauen wir mal. Auch diesmal. Ja, auch diesmal bringt er den Turm zum Einsturz. Mal langsam. Aber er tut sich schon schwerer. Also man sieht, das ist hier unten. Hier unten drücken etliche Fragmente hier rein und schieben sich wahrscheinlich gegenseitig. Haben die echt ein Kilo? Ja, Moment, ich will die Fragmente. Ja, ein Kilo. Ein Kilo. Ein Kilo. Und die Stangen hier haben 20.000 Kilo und trotzdem haut er die bei der Explosion weg. Ist schon erstaunlich. Hätte ich jetzt nicht gedacht. Ich dachte, die prallen erstmal ab. Naja, gut. So. So, next, let me make the bullet even before I make the cannon. I switch to layer 4 here. Layer 4 is the layer for all this stuff which is flying and shooting. I will try the number 18. So 18 says no, not 18, it's 17 artillery. Move animation slider to the starting frame, select bullet object, add them to collection A. Next, select the target object and press this button. Okay, this means I need first the bullet object. I take a cone for that. Where is it? Ah, the cone is here, okay. We want the cone to be here. And I will rotate the cone a bit. And change the size a bit. So it looks a bit more like a bullet. And move it up a bit. Shouldn't be in the floor. Yeah, oh. I pressed the wrong button. No. So here's the bullet and there's the target. So first the bullet. Must be in a size where we later make the cannon, okay? And then I put it into collection A. For this, I can directly go to button 16 and press the right mouse button. This is the same as if I would go to layer 1 and press the node A button. Who is starting all the blender here? Okay. So, bullet we have in location. I need to set the starting frame is frame 20. This is when the bullet starts flying. And now I need to set the target position. For this, I just take an empty. And this empty is where? Here. The target position should be here somewhere. Here somewhere. So, target position is selected. Bullet is in collection A. So I can already press the button 17. And now Blender will be busy for a few moments. So after 28 seconds of baking, there's already some movement visible here with the tower on the right side. Ah, okay. Okay, let's see what happens. We go a little bit more close here. So we see that the towers are not very stable. They already fall from themselves, but now comes the bullet. It flies here to the target position and explodes. and the exploding part from the bullet destroy the first tower. Now the second bullet comes, also explodes, destroys the second tower, and so on. Okay. Now let's see, what can we do to make the towers more stable? We can try a high quality bake. For this I go here and press the left mouse button. And then what we see is the baking now takes a lot longer. So it will not be ready in 26 seconds. It takes 0.5 to 0.7 seconds per frame. And so we will just wait. This is the first thing. If towers are not stable, you need to bake them with higher quality, then they will get stable. If the construction is right, of course. What you also see, after some time, the speed of the baking starts running here. And this is the case when the towers have already been fallen, then it gets faster. So, here we are. Let's see how it looks. First shot. Bam. Second. Bam. Bam. Is funny. Again. Also, the towers are not yet perfectly stable. Okay, what can we do? Let's experiment a bit. Okay, we are in layer 1. I select one of these tower elements and I say select similar size. Then I get all the tower elements selected. I go to the rigid body system and I increase the weight by 10 times. And I do the surface response with much more friction. It must not be bouncy. Naja, that's okay. What means sensitivity? Collision margin. Maybe we give it even a collision margin. So, and now this will only, it's only one object. So for now, I first need to press copy and then bake. Again, this is going to take a while. And you will see here, when the towers have fallen, the speed will increase. So now it speeds up. We are at frame 80, 90. Looks like at least one of the two towers has already fallen, and now it gets faster. Now the second tower has fallen at frame 140 around. Now it gets really fast, so now all the towers have fallen. Okay, there is one more thing we can do. Where is it? Deactivate. I think that was the deactivate button, because we can... Okay, but let's first see what happens. So, play. Okay, the towers are not yet perfectly stable. No big difference. So only changing the weight, you see they have all 20,000 kilos now. The weight to 20,000 did not yet solve the problem. So the first thing I will do, I will again make 200 1000. This will make them even more stable. I will copy. Of course, I need to select them first. Copy. So, and before I bake, I want to make one change. I will press the deactivation button and increase this. So, and next we can press copy and bake. So, as expected, it's a little bit small at the start again. 0.5 to 0.7 per frame. Okay, what you see is before it took 33 seconds for baking and 22 minutes 23, and now it was 2 minutes 55 because we have additional planks in the scene. But let's see now. Okay. So the first tower is not very stable. Maybe we should work on that. It has only 2000 kilo per plank, that's why. The bullet comes and destroys the tower with the explosion. So okay, from what I see, I would do a few changes. So first, I will select all these bullets. These are the explosion bullets. They are in a separate collection. So I will only give them a weight of 20 and make them much more light. So they have much less power, and of course I need to copy that. Now the main bullet has the main cone. It's not even a rigid body at the moment, so that should be. So, and bake it one more time. So, lately we arrived at 3 minutes and 7 seconds baking time. Let's see how it looks. Bullet comes. Okay. So the small bullets do not make so much damage anymore. So this is the bullet comes, shoots through the tower. Then what happens? Ah yeah, and then the bullet explodes and destroys the tower. So I would like to know what weight do the explosion fragments have. 82 kilo. Okay. And the planks have 2000 kilo from this tower. So what I will do is, I will select the planks from the quad tower and give them also 4 million kilos. Copy and bake. So after 3 minutes we are back. But there is not a large difference. Even so, we have now 4 million kilogram per plank. It's still exploding like it's from paper. I wonder why. 4 million kilogram and it just explodes like this. Okay. Okay, so we have the raw construction of the video. And we have the environment. So now let's get a little bit of materials and this stuff. So first this one, which material? Maybe sort of wood is nice here. Lighter wood, here it is. About the plank towers, it's just enough to give any of the planks a material. The whole planks are linked duplicates, so they will automatically get the same material like one plank. And you see these both are even together and choose the same material. So now let's take the bullets. They will get a special material and they will get a shining bright material. So, and finally, we need to make some setting changes. Bloom. And let's see how it looks. Okay. So, next I will switch to cycles and do some changes. So the video settings I will take HD video settings. Okay. And we need to do a bit compositing to get the flare around the bullets. Add filter glare. And we want fog glow. Change the background a bit. You can easily set camera keyframes using in layer 5, button 3, just press the left mouse button. This will set a camera keyframe. So you can have even another object selected, doesn't play a role here for this. Just press the left mouse button here and this will set a camera keyframe from the camera that you see here. And the last keyframe, maybe one more at the end. So let's see from start. We start here. We don't see the bullets flying here. Okay, we need another starting keyframe. So, a little bit up. So, this could be a good starting keyframe. Let's see. Okay, so let's render it.